Hello everyone, how are you all? I hope you all are fine and you are doing your study well. Is it? Okay. So welcome again in our music classes. Okay. As you know, we have started our new topic, that is Raag, and we have finished some sessions before this. Okay. In that session, you have already learned what is Raag, definition of raag, or some characteristics, rule of raag, and you learned about thaat also, and how the thaat and raag are depend on each other. Okay, how we can identify which raag, which thaat. Okay, so all these things you have learned already. Okay, so we can say that the description part or the introduction part we have done now, right? So now we are starting in this lesson some examples of raag. Okay, some basic raag now we are taking, right? So open your notebook, take your notebook, pencil, pen, whatever material you need. Okay, and you have to write down which is I'm given on giving on green board. Okay, so here we start. So first example of raag is, you can see on board, raag bhu. Okay, and some are saying is as raag bhupali. Okay, but in short we can say the raag bhu. Got it? Now we'll see the full description of this raag. Okay, so see, I have written already thaat, jati, vadi swar, samvadi swar, swars, vargin swar, gayan samay, okay, aroha, avroha, and pakad. In this, before this, the last session, in the last session, we have learned about this definitions. That means what is jati, what is vadi swar, what is samvadi swar in raag. Okay, so that you know and you have to recite that. Okay, so revise that session and now tell me one by one what is thaat, what is jati, what is vadi swar, what is samvadi swar. Okay, so by that definition now you have to describe this thaat or this raag. Okay, so now we'll start here. So this is first basic raag, raag bhupali. Okay, now from which thaat this raag is there, can you tell? Okay, now I will tell you, because this is the first example only. Okay, so the thaat of this raag is kalyan. So you have to write here which is the thaat. Okay, the thaat of this raag is thaat kalyan. Okay, so from thaat kalyan this bhup raag is there. Okay, yes. So now next is jati. Now tell me what is jati, or I can ask that definition of jati we have learned already. Okay, this depends, this jati is depends on, yes, number of swars which are there in particular raag. Okay, so of jati of this raag is odav. Okay, have you remember, we learned already three types of jati are there: odav, shadav, and sampurna. Now odav means what? Five swars. If five swars are there, then we can call it as odav swar, odav jati. If six are there, then we can say shadav, and if all swars, that means seven swars are there, then we can say it is of sampurna. So what is the zati of this rag? It is odar. Okay. Now next, vadi swar. Now what is mean by vadi swar? What is the definition? Just recall the last session. Yes, vadi swar means the first most important swar of the particular rag. Okay. So now, can you tell me about this? Have you heard anywhere the description of this rag? Okay. So vadi swar of this rag is ga. That means what is the vadi swar? It is ga. Okay. That means the most important swar in this rag is ga. Now, can you tell me the full name of ga? You already learned before this. Yes, ga means gandhar. Okay. Ga means gandhar. Yes. So next is samvadi swar. Now, what is mean by samvadi swar? Vadi swar is means the most important swar in the rag. Then what is samvadi swar? Yes, samvadi swar means the second most important swar from rag is called as samvadi swar. Okay. So now which is the samvadi swar in this rag? Yes, it is dha. Okay. The samvadi swar in this rag is dha, and what is the full name of dha? It is dhaivat. Okay? Yes. So now next is swars. Now what is this means? Why these swars are written here? Okay? So you have to tell about each and every rag, or in each and every rag, that how many swars are, if there are komal swar, if there are teevra swar. Okay, so in this swars you have to mention that. Okay, is there any teevra swar, is there any komal swar, or if all swars are shuddha. Okay, so this information you have to write here. Got it? So in this rag, in this example, all swars are shuddha. No any komal swar, no any teevra swar. Okay? So you have to write here, all swars are shuddha. Okay? Is it done? Up to swar? Yes. Now what is next? Next is varjit swar. Now what is mean by varjit swar? Okay, the swar is, we can leave that swar from a particular rag. Okay, so that is called as varjit swar. Okay, so now which swar is there in this rag as a varjit swar? Or which swars are there? Okay, it may be two swars, it may be three swars. Yes, have you revised the all the sessions? Just recall that minimum how many swars we can take in rag? Yes, minimum 5 swars we have to take in each and every rag. Okay, so by this rule, we have to take 5 swars. Okay, and we already mentioned here the zati is oda. That means already 5 swars are there in this rag. Okay, so which swars, how many swars we are leaving? 2 swars. And which are they? Yes, ma and ni. Okay, these both swars are varjit swar from this rag. So you have to write here which swars are not there. Ma and ni. Okay. Have you remember about this? Yes. The Gayan Samar means the timing of a particular timing of singing that particular raag. Okay. Now what is the Gayan Samar of this particular raag? This Bhoop raag. Yes. That is first prahar of the night. Means now what is mean by prahar? Okay, you know about hours. How many hours are there in one day? 24 hours. Yes. So prahar means a particular time of a particular hours. Okay, there are 8 prahars in a one day. So how many prahars are there? Can you tell? 8 prahars or one of in a one day, that means how many prahars are there? Already I have told 8 prahars are there. Okay, so only 8 prahars are in a one day. Yes, so can you tell me about the timing or period of one prahar? Yes, see, in a one day 24 hours are there. Okay, in a one day 24 hours are there. Okay, yes, and already I have told now in one day how many prahars are there. 8 prahars are there. Okay, now can you tell me the period of one prahar? So one prahar is of how many hours? Yes, of 3 hours. Okay, how many hours? Yes, one prahar is of 3 hours. Okay, so now got it? One prahar is of 3 hours. That means in a one day 8 prahars are there. Okay, so in this pattern the Gayan Samay is there, and we have to tell about each and every raag. The Gayan Samay is in this type, in prahar type. Okay, so just for your information I have given this, but you have to remember this. That means in a one day 24 hours, in a one day 8 prahars are there, and in one prahar 3 hours are there. Okay, so just write down this, and now we'll move towards our this raag. Okay, so now Gayan Samay of this raag, which prahar? Yes, the first prahar at night, that means 7 pm to 10 pm. Okay, this is the first prahar of night time. Yes, so you have to write here first prahar at night. Okay, that means what? 7 pm to 10 pm. Write down here 7 PM to 10 PM. Okay, so have you done this all the features? Yes. So now we'll move towards Aroha and Avroha. So now tell me how many swars are there in this raag? See what we written here, Odav Zati. So five swars we have to take in this raag, or we can say 5 swars are there in this raag. Okay, so now which are they? And we have to leave these 2 swars, ma and ni, because of this raag, this swar is virgin swar. We cannot take these 2 swars in this raag. Okay, so by that, leaving these 2 swars, we have to write the Aroha and Avroha. So see the Aroha, Sa, Re, So na pa dha, and we are leaving this ni also. See, ma and ni are vargit swar. Yes. So sa re ga pa dha, and the sa is from yes, upper octave, that means tar sakta. Okay, so can you count this 1 2 3 4 and 5? 5 main swars are there. Okay, so sa re ga pa dha sa. Okay, this is the aroha of this rag. Now avroha, that means ascending and descending order. So now you have to write avroha, that means from this sa sa dha pa ga re sa. Okay, is it done? Yes. Now you got aroha and avroha both with the order zati, that means with the 5 swars. Okay, now last one is pakad. Now what is mean by pakad? See, it is pakad. So can you tell definition of pakad? Yes, the main phrase or catch phrase of this particular rag. That means from pakad we can tell a particular name of that rag. Okay, so now what is the pakad or what is the catch phrase of this rag? Yes, that is ga re sa dha, that is ga re sa dha. Sa re ga pa ga re sa. Okay, this is a catch phrase of this rag. Okay, now if I am giving only this phrase, so by that can you tell the name of rag? Because see, vargit swar, that is ma and ni are not there. Yes, so next is ga. Ga is the most important, that is vadi swar. Most important swar are there, swar is there. That means ga, how many times given? See, yes, and the samvadi swar dha, that means the next second most important swar, that is also given. Okay, so that means this catch phrase is important in a particular rag. Okay, so we'll finish our session here. This is the first example of rag, that is basic rag, that means rag ghu. Okay, this is a description of this rag. And one thing is also there, that is sargam geet. Okay, there is a particular song is there in which only notes are there, words are not there. Okay, only this notation or only this verse are there. Okay, that will take in next session. Okay, first we'll just learn some basic rag and the description of basic rag. Okay, see, this aroha, avroha and pakad, I will show you on harmonium in next session. Okay, or further anywhere. Okay.